Okay, so good morning guys and welcome to another Cabal Mobile content. If you are going to play Cabal Mobile and you never had an experience in playing Cabal Mobile in Thailand or mobile in Korea, or you never had an experience in Cabal Online itself in PC, this video is the right video for you. So I'll try my best to show you the gameplay of this game in a way that you will be familiarized with the gameplay, so that before the release of this game, you already have an idea and you already know what to do, what to prepare, and the most important, what mistakes to avoid in early days. Okay, so here in the first part of this video, I'll be sharing my journey of leveling up from level 1 to level 100. And to be honest guys, I'm not really a pro player of Cabal. I'm still learning a lot until now regarding to this game. That's why the video or the gameplay that you're going to see is actually my first try of playing Cabal Mobile from level 1 to level 100. So right now, while you are watching this video, you can imagine or think that I am just like you. Like you're the one who is playing. So we are the same noob or same newbie, but as we try playing the game together from level 1 to level 100, we will learn a lot together, especially from the mistakes I made in my first try here in Cabal M. Honestly, I made a lot of mistakes in my first try, and these are the mistakes that we should avoid in the official release of Cabal M. So again, I encourage you not to skip any part of this video, because I'll be sharing some tips and the mistakes that we should avoid randomly in the video. Okay, at first, of course, I created my character and I chose Force Archer, and on the early days or on the early part of my journey, like level 1 to level 50, the game looks so boring. Yeah, so it looks so boring. So the same with you, you might be bored on the early part of the game, because what you're going to do on the early part of the game is more on clicking and also talking to the NPC. Basically, you are more on doing the quest, because AFK grinding, guys, AFK grinding on early game is not really ideal. Doing quests is much better, like 10 times or 20 times better in terms of leveling up on early days. And then after 2 hours, I am already level 52. Honestly, it's really fast. I never do AFK farming here. I just keep on clicking and doing the quest, but I already reached level 52. And at this point, I'm still doing the same thing. So I keep on clicking and clicking, but this stage was the time that somehow I started enjoying watching my own characters doing some cool skills. And also guys, quick tip, based on my experience as Force Archer, so I'm not sure with the other class, but as Force Archer, you really don't need to buy any expensive equips or gears on early days in order to finish your quest. All quests on early game are achievable without expensive equips. So save your money on the later part of the game. So you don't need to think of the equips that you're going to use in early days. Just keep equipping the gears or the equips that you are getting from the monsters and from the quest. And I assure you guys that you will be doing fine. And also, once you reach level 100 plus, you are actually going to get a lot of equips. Like every quest that you have, your rewards will be plus 8 slotted item. Just like this video that I'm showing you now, these are the finished quests with the plus 8 rewards. So I recorded all of this so that you will see the evidence that I am getting plus 8 items. And then based on my experience, before you reach level 117, you will be able to complete already all of your plus 8 slotted set. So in other words, on the early days, you really don't need to spend money in the market for your equips. That's why my suggestion or my advice is just stick to the click gameplay. So you're just going to keep on clicking your quests and then doing it automatically. So again, on early days, don't think of the gears that you're just going to wear. So that's the quick tip. Okay, so after 6 hours of gaming, I already reached level 75. And guys, this quest in Ruina Station is the first quest that is so challenging. Yeah, it's one of the hardest quests that you are going to have in your journey. That's why here, you are seeing that my character is really having a hard time. Like, it's so hard for me to kill these boss monsters. Like, so impossible. It's really hard, super hard for a first archer. Okay, so guys, in this part I made a mistake. This is actually my first mistake that you should avoid, so listen carefully with this so that you will understand the main concept of this mistake. Here in Cabal M, you need to learn that there are actually two types of dungeons. There are two types of dungeons that you are going to encounter in your quest. I will call the first one as solo or free dungeon. I call it free because you can enter there anytime you want. And then the other type of dungeon is we're going to call it not free dungeon. So basically this one is the opposite. This is like the dungeon that you need something like ticket or an entry ticket before you can enter. And here in this dungeon, Fort Ruina, this one is actually the second type of dungeon that I mentioned. It is a not free dungeon, meaning you're going to spend tickets here every time you're going to enter. And I realized that we should not waste the entry or the tickets that we have, especially on the early days of the game. What I mean by that is once we enter this type of dungeon for our quest, we make sure first that we are not just going to do the quest inside the dungeons. Instead, we are going to finish the dungeons itself so that we will not be wasting our tickets or our entries. Yeah, because I have an experience before when I was level 100 plus. I have a quest inside the dungeon called SOD. My quest was to kill some specific monsters inside that dungeon, and at that time I have SOD entry or ticket in my inventory, so I use it. And then I'm so surprised that the dungeon is also super hard, so in the end I died. And I'm trying to enter again and I have no more SOD ticket or entry, so I need to buy it in the market. And then I'm so surprised that the ticket in the market is really expensive. The ticket cost, and I'm sure it will be the same with the Ruina entry or Ruina tickets on the early days of this game. It will be also expensive because this will be one of the in-demand tickets. Players will be needing this on the early days. That's why I realized that on early days, every time you have a quest that requires you to enter to the second type of dungeon, the not free dungeon, make sure you will be able to finish that run or that dungeon, or else you're going to waste your entry or your ticket, or in short, your money. But anyway, back to the story here. When I was not able to finish Fort Ruina dungeon when I was level 75, what I did in this part is I skipped this quest first, and then I tried to do different quests, and I found out that there are so many quests that you can do aside from this one. So quick tip, once this quest regarding Fort Ruina appears around level 75, guys, skip it first. Try to do the other quests and level up as much as possible before you can do this quest. Yeah, so anyway, based in my experience, I keep doing the quest before until I reach level 81. And also I bought important skill passive books like this. And second mistake, guys, I made a mistake again. This is now the second mistake that you should avoid. Okay guys, these mistakes that I'm sharing are the mistakes that I realized when I already reached the higher level. So the mistake here is I bought this healing passive skill, and I don't know that I will be able to get this free book from the quest. That's why here I already have the skill and I also have the extra book. and I will not be able to use this book anymore because I already have the skill, and this one is really expensive. So my quick tip for you is don't buy skill books, especially the active skill books. I mean the skills that you can use to attack monsters. Don't buy it, because based on my experience, I got all of my active skill books here for free. Yeah, all of these are for free from doing the quest. So don't waste your money buying books. Okay, back to my story. I'm already level 81 and I already tried to level up more from doing the other quests, and I already fixed my skills. So I tried the Ruina Station again, yeah, the quest, and you can see now in the video I made it. Yeah, so yeah, of course, because I am now stronger. So after this quest, I went back to my routine, which is the clicking gaming. So I keep on clicking and clicking again. But this time, guys, I'm really enjoying my character very much because the skills are so good to watch. I really like the animation. Okay, so after 15 hours, yes guys, 15 hours of gaming, I reached level 95 plus. And at this period, I was stuck with my quests. Like all the quests that I have are really super hard. I'm sure that in your journey, time will come that you will not be able to finish all of the quests that you have, just like my experience here. So when these things happen to you, like this one, like you're stuck with your quest, this is the time you need to change your routine. You need to level up more, not by doing the quest, but by doing other routine, which is dungeon runs, if you have entry tickets. So you need to level up more by doing dungeon runs. Okay, so quick tip, guys, every time I'm running the Fort Arena dungeon, I really make sure that the entry that I use will be super used or super maximized. What I mean is I don't finish the run quickly. Instead, I'm staying here in this spot, the bull spot, to grind for XP and for loots until the time remaining I have is 5 minutes, because I think I will be able to kill the final boss and finish this run for 5 minutes. And then there you go. Okay, so we just killed the boss and finished the dungeon. Yeah, but sad to say, we are not able to level up. That's why what I did here is I did an AFK farming for a moment, and then there you go. So I leveled up here, and now because we level up, we are able to unlock new quests. And anyway, we can go back to our original routine again, which is doing the quest, and hopefully this new quest that I have will be easier, like a quest that you're just going to talk to NPC. So basically, a quick tip again, this is the basic routine that you can follow in the game. First, you can do the click gaming, which is doing the quest. Second, if you cannot do the quest anymore, run some dungeons. Third, if you are very busy and you cannot do any of the two, like quests and dungeons, just do AFK farming. Fourth, if you are really super busy, just log out and rest. So don't forget that we only play to rest from real life and to have fun. But anyway, back again to my story. After 20 hours, yes, 20 hours of gameplay, we already reached level 100. So 20 hours of gaming, as first timer of playing Kawal M, we reached level 100. So that's our first record. But anyway guys, I think that's the end of our content, and I hope you learned something in this video. And don't forget to click the subscribe if you want to be more updated with Kabal M contents. I'll be uploading more regarding to Kabal M. Anyway, thank you very much for supporting this channel, and happy gaming to all of you.